In this Epiphan U training video, we're going to cover Webcaster X2 and how to get up and running up into the point of actually streaming. So the equipment that is required and how to connect the equipment to the device and the confidence monitoring UI and the basics of how to navigate and make setting changes in that. But before you begin, you need a few things. You need a few items. As you can see on my desk, I have a few items. So the first thing you need is a video source. I have a Canon G20 camera here. And I also have my Webcaster X2, of course, over here. And an Ethernet cable to connect to my network. And you can see my monitor. So the purpose of this monitor, the Webcaster outputs to it. So you can monitor for user engagement, like comments, and respond to the comments, and make changes to your settings and whatnot, and see your live feed. It's a very handy tool. You also have a mouse. So the mouse connects to the Webcaster, so you can make changes and navigate the UI that I just mentioned. So I'm going to change views here really quickly so you can see up close. There we go, in the side cam. So here's my Webcaster X2 right here. And if I rotate it, I can see my LAN port to connect my cable, my Ethernet cable, and then a couple of USB ports. I can pick one of those and connect my mouse. HDMI out connects to the external monitor. And if I rotate the device over here, I can see another USB port and an HDMI in where I would connect my camera source. So I'm going to just quickly make these connections. So I'll connect my network cable and then my mouse. And then on the other side, I'll connect my camera. And lastly, I will connect my external monitor. So I will change views once more so you can see. So now the monitor has come to life. And I will zoom in again. So you can see this is the YouTube version. So you can see your video feed and you can see an overlay and options to make changes and start your stream and whatnot. As I just mentioned, that's YouTube. Great if you're streaming to YouTube, not so great if you want to stream to Facebook. So to change to Facebook, you double press. There's a button on the side of the device. You can kind of feel it with your finger, a little groove. You double press that, and the monitor, after a few moments, will change to the Facebook version. So what you're seeing right here is a pairing code. This is a little bit beyond the video, but essentially this code you would use to connect your Facebook account. You would pair it to the device. And once paired, you could then start your stream, start streaming. But we don't need this now, so we'll close this. So in this interface, again, you can see your video feed. And you can see a few options. Pair, I just talked about that. Preferences and settings. So if you go into settings, there's a few, well, more than a few, a bunch of different options you can change in settings. But the most important one is Wi-Fi. So the device actually doesn't have to connect wire via a wire. It can connect wirelessly as well. So if you click on that, you can see a number of different options. And you can click on one of these networks and connect as you normally would to any other device. So to get out, you right-click out, right-click again. If you're going into preferences, there's a few points of interest. Again, there's a lot of different preferences that you can change. Scrolling through it quickly, you can see. But the main ones to be concerned about are at the top. So there's encoding resolution. So you can make your changes to the resolution, as well as video bitrate, you can see here. Like out of that. Also under Facebook details, you can see video title and video description. So you're gonna wanna make these changes to the video title before publishing, before starting your live stream, or else this default text will display instead. So again, video title and video description is just underneath. So I'm going to switch videos, or switch views rather, again. So that's essentially it. The equipment needed to get started with your Webcaster X2 and how to connect it, a quick overview of the ports, and the confidence monitoring interface. The next step is to use the pairing code. Pair your social media account, and then once that's paired, you start streaming. But that is best saved for a different video. So thanks for joining us. Please like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more Epiphan U content. Thanks.